pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Brethren, the Lord has answered our prayers this morning in Jesus' name. And we're going to remember our children specially, because something that is also obvious in the month of September is a new school year. And we're going to ask that the Lord will be with our children, from the least to the youths, all those in universities, that as they are going back to school, the Lord is going to give them a fresh understanding. Daniel 1:17 says, "As for these four children," call the names of your children. "As for these four children, God gave them knowledge and skill in all learning and wisdom. And Daniel had understanding in all visions and dreams." You're going to say, "Father, as our children go back to school, in the mighty name of Jesus, give them knowledge and skill. Give them knowledge and skill. Give them knowledge and skill in everything they learn. No subject will be difficult. Father, mathematics will not be difficult. English will not be difficult. Science will not be difficult. Economics will not be difficult. No subject will be difficult, because you gave Daniel knowledge and skill. My children, as they go back to school, nothing will be difficult for them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray." Jesus said to the disciples in Luke 18:16, when they were chasing away the children and as they were crowding towards him, Luke 18:16, he just asked that, "Let the children come to me. Suffer not these children. Let them come to me." Luke 18:16. He said, "Forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God." That scripture is so powerful. So we're going to pray, "Father, in the name of Jesus, our children will not fall away from the kingdom of God. As they go back to school, they will not learn evil doctrines. Those in the boarding houses, those in the universities, as they are going back to school, my Father, they will not fall away from you, because they are of your kingdom. They will not go to the kingdom of Satan. We block their brains from everything, oh God, that is contrary to the kingdom of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, our children will make us proud. They are for your kingdom. They will not go to the kingdom of Satan. In the name of Jesus Christ, our children will continue to make us proud. Our children will not bring shame to us, oh God. Even in our families, even in Canaanland, our students in the university, they will move souls for you. They will move kingdoms for you. In the name of Jesus, thank you, precious Father. We give you all the praise and glory. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Everlasting Father, King of glory, words are not enough to express how grateful we are to you, Lord, this morning. We thank you so much for all you have done in our lives. We thank you so much for all you have done concerning Nigeria. We thank you so much that we are still standing, even as a nation. We thank you, Lord, because there is freedom to worship you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, because we can move, we can breathe, we have eaten, we are wearing clothes, we are not naked. We thank you because we are healthy, we are not in the hospital. We thank you because we are not in prison. We thank you because we are free. Lord, we thank you, oh God, because you have preserved our going out and coming in. Many of us travel, even on a weekly basis. Lord, you shield us. We are grateful to you, Father. And so we ask, Lord, that in the name of Jesus, every prayer said here by your children, Father, we say an amen, and they are answered in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. As you sit down, just wish somebody welcome to the month of September. Prophesy to that person, "September will do you good in the name of Jesus. September will do me good in the mighty name of Jesus." Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have any testimony, please, quickly, I'd like you to move, directly in front of me and meet Sister Vivian. just right in front of me. If you have a testimony, please just go to the back and meet her so that right after we collect the tithes, you can come forward. Praise the name of the Lord. At this point, I want to call on all tithers in the house. We are all tithers by the grace of God. I hope we know that. Because as long as we earn any income, whether it is salary, money from business, pension, whatever it is, gifts, you are supposed to give God a tenth of that collection. Many people say, oh, my salary is too small, I cannot pay tithe. I'm sorry, if you cannot pay tithe on 10,000 naira, I don't know if you will pay on 10 million. And you have to pay so that the Lord will bless you. The blessings that he has promised in Malachi 3:8 and even from verse 10 shall be yours as we obey in this season, in the name of Jesus. Please begin to come forward, because God wants to do a new thing in somebody's life. And one of the things that we would do as his children is to obey and position ourselves for the new. And one of such is paying your tithe. So if you have not even been paying your tithe, you know, from the beginning of this year, please position yourself for God to do a new thing by stepping out and presenting that tithe, that 10% to God. You can write a check in favor of RCCG Canaanland or ask the ushers for your POS. If you don't have cash here and you are moved by the message, please ask the ushers for a POS. You can use your ATM card to pay your tithe. Please do not eat your seed. Do not eat your blessing. Please bring the tithes forward and the Lord will bless you. As you've done that, please lift up your tithes and say, Father, I thank you. You are the one that gives power to make wealth, according to Deuteronomy 8:18. Thank you for the power that you have given me to bring this to you. Thank you for how you sustain my work. Thank you for how you sustain my business. Thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. In the name of Jesus, as I bring this tithes to you, Father, I pray that you will take away every devourer in my life, in the mighty name of Jesus. As I drop this tithe, I will not treat illness, in the name of Jesus. As I drop this tithe, my money will not be lost, in the name of Jesus. As I drop this tithe, I will not make wrong investments, in the name of Jesus. As I drop this tithe, you will promote me from glory to glory, in the name of Jesus. You will increase the fruit of my body. You will increase the fruit of my work. You will increase the fruit of everything that concerns me, because your word says that I should go and I should be fruitful and I multiply. In the name of Jesus, as our daddy in the Lord has proclaimed, as I drop this tithe, there will be no more fruitless effort in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You may please drop your tithe. God bless you. Praise the Lord. I'd like to call Mrs. Henrietta Aselime for her testimony. Please come forward quickly, ma. God bless you. Canaanland, please. Let's praise the Lord for Sister Henrietta Aselime. Where is she? Okay. Please, let's give God praise. She's coming up. Let's encourage our sister. God bless you, ma.
Praise the Lord. Children of God, praise the Lord. I've come to return all glory to God for preservation of life. Some months back, a couple came out here to give thanks to God for preserving the life of their baby. And I was right there thinking, please pardon me. I was right there thinking, what could they have gone through? You know, if something hasn't happened to you, you won't understand what people talk about. And sometime in April, just on my way back from work, I was rushing back home and I was involved in an accident. I was on a bike, you know, just rushing to get home to cook. And a car ran into me and my bones got broken, that's fractured. Rushed to the hospital. I can't start giving details of all that God did for me. But brethren, I've come to tell you that God is a faithful God. if you serve God indeed, it is good to serve Him in spirit and in truth. I've come to give all glory to God for a praying and a supportive husband. He kept me alive. The psalmist says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Brethren, people say they are not scared to die. On the day of the surgery, I was scared. I couldn't sleep. The doctors just did everything possible to keep me awake because the devil was after my life. He was going to take me, but God kept me alive. He gave me grace not to sleep, because if I had slept that day, I knew I was not going to wake up. But God kept me alive. Oh, Father, I just want to give God thanks this morning.
Hallelujah.
Doctors were confused. I'm sorry, ma. When we watch our own videos and we see doctors running helter-skelter, we say, what's wrong with all these ones? Why are they exaggerating? When I saw it happening in my presence, doctors were confused. They didn't know what to do. It was just from the bone fracture, and it went on to blood clots. Blood, I couldn't breathe. Took me to ICU. I was not myself. I was not alive. I was looking at people. I couldn't talk. To talk was a heavy thing to me. But thank you, Jesus. When it says some have food but cannot eat, some can eat but have no food, what do we say? We have food and we can eat, and we give all glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, church. I just want to also appreciate our Father in the Lord and every minister that we're able to pray for us, because when our Father in the Lord called to wish her happy birthday, I was one that took the phone and I explained to him what happened, and he was like, wow. So I really want to appreciate him as a father, because he came to that hospital and he said something. He said, I said to myself that I will come to this place before I go to bed. By 11 p.m. he was there. He prayed with us, and he was just there as a father. I just want to appreciate him. And he also invited some other ministers to pray with us. We really want to appreciate the people of God who intercede for us. And the Almighty God will bless you richly in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Congratulations, sir. And please, 1 minute, we want to pray and thank God on your behalf. Congregation, what an awesome God. Please, can we stretch our hands to this beautiful couple and say, Father, we thank you. Because you have given them the grace to stand before your presence this morning, stand before your people to say thank you. Father, we appreciate you. Father, Lord, even as they have testified, your word says we overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Father, we decree unto them that in the name of Jesus, they are permanent overcomers in Jesus' name. Their testimony will remain permanent, and this will be the least that you, the Lord, will do for them in their lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Shola.
Yes, Ngazi.
I need to hear God myself.
You need to scrape this off. 4 months.
What's the problem?
You're already scared, right? Don't worry, it's gonna work.
I work on it, I love my position.
Open the bonnet.
Because you see every mechanic hitting something, doesn't mean every car problem requires hitting.
Love this Ngozi girl. Take good care of our daughter. She's very precious to us.
It's not easy, sir.
For a weak man. It is not easy for a weak man. How can you be tired of a journey you've not even started?
Why are you always falling sick? Why?
Why?
Whose voice are you paying attention to? The voice of God or the voice of your friends?
Is this what you'll be telling us?
Together for the youth fellowship. So well, with the preview that you have just watched, the youth fellowship is glad to invite you to the movie night on Saturday the 10th of September 2016 here in the church auditorium. The time is 5 p.m. Again, youth fellowship's movie night. I believe the movie is The Ignition, from what we saw now, the preview. Saturday, 10th of September, which is the coming Saturday, at the church auditorium, or in the church auditorium. And the time is 5 p.m. prompt. So all the youth, your date has been announced. Make sure you are there, and the Lord bless you as you attend in Jesus' name. Are we happy to be in church this morning? Then let your face show someone that you are happy to be in church this morning. It's a beautiful thing to be in the presence of the Most High God. This is the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Canaanland. And there is more after that name, but I will let the senior pastor tell you about it at the appropriate time. We welcome everyone to today's service, especially those worshiping with us for the first time. We have our services on Sunday, starting from 8:15 with Sunday school. And then to the family service, which is what we are in now at 9 a.m. Tuesdays, we dig deep into the Word of God from 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. And on Thursdays, we pray in our faith clinic service from 6:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. You can also join our online activities by logging on to our Facebook and Twitter accounts, RCCG Canaanland Lekki, for both of them, and get spiritually refreshed as you do so, in Jesus' name. We plead with those who pledged towards the church renovation to please endeavor to redeem their pledges, either through checks written in favor of RCCG Canaanland Special Project or with cash given directly to the church accountant. Those who intend to support the renovation now, that is, who haven't made a pledge but wish to do so, can do the same. This is our Father's house. Let's do what we need to do to make it beautiful, to make it accommodating, to make it comfortable. God bless us as we obey in Jesus' name. Our monthly Holy Communion service comes up on Tuesday, 6th of September 2016, immediately after our Digging Deep session, that is this Tuesday. Holy Communion is a meal that heals on every side. It heals spiritually, physically, it heals financially. It's a rejuvenation meal. So you are advised to come if you are desirous of healing in any of these areas, or if you just want to identify with Christ. He said, do this often in what? In remembrance of me. So on Tuesday, after our Digging Deep, we will have Holy Communion. Come and dine at the table of the Lord. The choir department wishes to invite those who want to join the choir and ask that you wait to see the minister in charge of the choir or the music director immediately after service. So if you feel you can minister, please wait behind after service and you can see the head of the choir or the music director. The choir themselves will wait behind for a meeting after service today. New Life Initiative is a corporate social responsibility initiative supported by Canaanland, which caters to out-of-home youth in the Lekki Axis. with a view to reconciling these children with their families and rehabilitating them, you know, where possible, financially, socially, and otherwise. We're looking for volunteers who can teach basic subjects to these youth and who can also counsel the young women who are being rehabilitated. So if you feel you can be a blessing in this area, you don't have to have formal teaching degrees or, you know, have taught in a school. If you just feel you can teach a basic subject, you can teach math, you can teach English, you can teach science, something to empower these children to be able to make a way ahead in life, please see us in the church office. You can ask for Brother Philip or Dama, or you can ask for any of the church office staff and tell them you are interested, and we would be happy to put your name down. God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. We're giving sound training in the church, and that is training in being able to technically master sound, production of sound, musical sound, audio sound, like as I'm speaking now. So all who are interested, to please see the head of technical audio, Deacon Steve, in the cubicle at the back there after service, if you want to be part of that training. We plead with all our members who have not filled the church membership form this year. We're doing, you know, a review of our database. So if you've not taken a form this year and filled your details in, you know, so that we can, you know, update what we have on our records, please speak to any of the ushers. They will give you the form, you will complete it, and we will be able to enter your information into our database. With that, I'd like to ask, by the way, if you have never received or you have not been receiving lately SMS messages headed Canaanland, can you just wave your hand? You have never received or you have not been receiving, okay, lately. So ushers, please, just keep those hands up slightly above your head. Yes, they'll bring the paper to you. God bless you. Also, there are vacancies for the following roles in church. We have the accountant position, assistant administrator, admin officer, and personal assistant. Again, accountant, assistant administrator, admin officer, and personal assistant. All CVs should be sent to RCCG LP67. RCCG LP67 at gmail.com. So please send your CVs, and if you couldn't get that down or you don't have the CVs here and you have them later, you can just bring them and drop them in the church office and indicate which of the positions you are interested in. Now, a new RCCG calendar year starts every September, so we're actually in a new year now, praise the Lord. And we're using this as a time to announce again that, you know, you can join a house fellowship near you. The house fellowship is meant to be a closer unit where the church can reach you personally, can counsel with you regarding your issues, and you can be prayed for. You have a community, a small group that fellowship with you and that you fellowship with. Please take advantage of the house fellowships. We have house fellowships at Chevron Drive. We have house fellowships here in Goshen Estate. We have in the Goshen community just outside the estate. We have in the UPDC estate. We have at Lakwe Bogije area, and we have in Admiralty, which is the other side of the expressway in phase one. And we're opening more as we go along very soon. Ikate, Osapa, London, we will have fellowships there. Please check the notice board. There is a notice there already with the house fellowship details. Please look for the one closest to you, and God bless you as you attend in Jesus' name. The new workers who put down their names after Pastor Akishaye preached last Sunday, you were supposed to have a class this morning at 7 a.m. You received a message, so you know yourselves. Can you just wait on these red seats for a brief meeting with me after service? The new workers or new intending workers, God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. It's offering time. No, that's not convincing now. It's offering time. Ah, that sounds more like it. So package your offering, and the choir will lead us in the hymn even as we give our offering today. Let's rise on our feet even as we ready to give her.
The Lord has done great things for us, whereof we are glad. This morning our hymn is Count Your Blessings, name them one by one. If the Lord has done anything for you, then you would count your blessings. You would know that the Lord has done great things for you. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what the Lord has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. It will surprise you what the Lord has done.
When upon life's pillows you are tempest tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one.
Exalt you. Thank you for the opportunity, Lord, to bring our substance, Lord, in worship, Lord God, and even in thanksgiving before you. Accept us and accept our offering in Jesus' name. Let it be useful for the work of your kingdom in your house. Cause men to give unto our own bosoms good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This morning we want to testify of God's goodness to us. We confess that everything has changed for us because the Lord has blessed us. He has blessed our going out. He has blessed our coming in. For this we are grateful to God. He has blessed our food. He has blessed our water. If the Lord has blessed you, I think you should just, you know, raise your voice and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That is our testimony this morning. Everything has turned around for us for good in the name of Jesus.
For the blessings, oh God, you'd increase my testimonies. Oh, see all the things you blessed me with. Oh, you know the fault, you know the fault my handle. Cause everything has changed
for me.
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 Oh, they have changed, though I.
Everything has changed.
You know the stress. They make me sweat. But you still they bless me. Can't be all see. You know they fall my hand. Everything has changed
for me.
Everything has changed
for me.
I'm singing praise
for me.
I'm prophesying with my family
for me.
I'm believing, yeah.
For me.
Oh!
as a light in a dark land. Down splits in your heart, all the Lord's command. He's standing above nations and kind of enemies the way. He's standing up inside of you. So let me hear you say, hey, blessed are
we. We're blessed in the sea.
We're blessed, yeah.
We're blessed in the field. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold of sin.
Your hands together for the Lord. It's a new month. It's a new day. It's a new season. It's a new dawn. It's a season of elevation, a season of promotion, a season of the new, a season of new power, new anointing, new strength, new accomplishments, new favors. Put your hands together. It's a new season. 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 In the spirit of the new season, we are going to sing a hymn in the bulletin.
In the spirit of the new season, in the spirit of the new day. It's not a day for too many words. It's a day for continuous praise and thanksgiving to the Almighty Father for a new day, a new season. New every morning is thy love. Our awakening and uprising proof. Through sleep and darkness safely brought, restored to life and power and thought. New every morning. This and every month. Help us this and every year. Help us this and every season to live more nearly, to be more like you, to be more fashioned after your likeness, as you pray. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's put our hands together for the Lord as we take our seats. Indeed, it is a new day. It's a new season. It's a new morning. The message this morning is titled The Season of Elevation. The Season of Elevation. And it's brought under the theme for the month, which is A New Dawn. A New Dawn. Based on Deuteronomy chapter 1, verses 6 to 8. Deuteronomy 1, 6 to 8, talking about the theme for the month. Deuteronomy chapter 1, verses 6 to 8. Let us read it together. 1, 2, go. The Lord our God spake unto us in Horeb, saying, ye have dwelled long enough in this mountain. Turn you and take your journey, and go to the mount of the Amorites, and unto all the places near thereunto, in the plain, in the hills, and the vale, and in the south, and by the seaside, to the land of the Canaanites, and unto Lebanon, unto the great river, the Euphrates. Can we have that as a New English Translation? New English Translation. Are we there? One, two, go. When we were at Mount Sinai, the Lord our God said to us, you have stayed at this mountain long enough. Not everybody is reading. It is time to break camp and move on. Go to the hill country of the Amorites and to all the neighboring regions, the Jordan Valley, the hill country, the western foothills, the Negev, and the coastal plain. Go to the land of the Canaanites and to Lebanon and all the way to the great Euphrates River. Verse 8. Look, I am giving all this land to you. Go in and occupy it. For it is the land the Lord swore to give to your ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and to all their descendants. Put your hands together for the Lord. That is the text of the theme for the moment. I want you to read over and over and over again in your private time. Praise the Lord. Commit this text to memory. Praise the Lord, because I'm sure it would probably form the basis of some of the messages that will be coming from this pulpit. But this morning, on the title, My Season of Elevation, which is taking Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7, which I'll be sharing a few things that the Lord has laid upon our heart at the beginning of this new season. Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7. Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7. Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7. My Father, my Lord, put a blessing upon your word this morning, O Lord. Let your word speak life to us. Let your word instruct us this morning. Let your word lead us. Let your word encourage us. Let your word teach us, O Lord, about your plans and purposes and about what you have laid out for us in this new season. To the glory and honor of your name, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. Verse 7. But God is the judge. He putteth down one and setteth up another. New English Translation, please. Or New Living Translation, please. Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7. The New Living Translation or New English Translation, please. Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7. Psalm 75, verses 6 to 7. For no one on earth, from east or west, or even from the wilderness, should raise a defiant fist. It is God alone who judges. He decides who will rise and who will fall. He decides who will rise and who will fall. One thing that, one of the attributes that God has is sovereignty. Ultimate sovereignty. Our God is the ultimate sovereign. A sovereign, for example, a king or somebody in authority may still have authorities over him, such that when he churns out instructions of authority which nobody can question, he may still need to refer to authorities that are over him. But when we talk of an ultimate authority, I talk of an authority, a sovereign that is not subject to any other sovereign. Because our God is the ultimate authority, is the ultimate sovereign. The Bible refers to him as the commander of the host of heavens, the Lord of lords, the King of kings, the one who is highly lifted up, the one who is not responsible to anyone. So because he's the ultimate authority, he pulls down one and he lifts off another. And he owes nobody any explanation. Promotion does not come from the four winds of the earth. It does not come from Abuja. It does not come from the kings and princes. They are mere vessels that God uses. What Psalm 75, 6 to 7 is telling us, that promotion comes only from God. Revelation chapter 3 verse 7 says, talking about Jesus Christ, he says he has the key of David. He shuts a door that no man can open. He opens a door which no man can shut. God's plan is not for us to be static or remain static in any of our lives or our operations or our business or our endeavors. That's why the first instruction he gave to man after creating man in Genesis chapter 1, 27, 28, he said, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it. Be fruitful, multiply. Be fruitful, multiply. So that clearly tells that God is not in the business of stagnation. God, as a matter of fact, abhors stagnation. God is upset when he sees those he has created, when they are stagnant, when they are not moving forward, when they are not progressing, when they are not fruitful. So God expects us to move. He expects us to progress. He expects us to walk towards elevation. However, as we walk in fruitfulness or towards fruitfulness, towards growth or multiplication, it is God that determines at what time, in what way, we shall receive that promotion. Are you hearing me this morning? God is not in the business of stagnation. He hates stagnation. Because he has created us to be fruitful, to multiply, to progress, to walk towards progress, towards enhancement, to walk towards promotion, towards elevation. But as we walk towards all of that, it is he ultimately that will determine when our promotion will come, when our elevation will come. So all our efforts may be geared towards promotion, all our efforts may be made to influence promotion, but it is God that ultimately determines when and how promotion will come. I have a friend, somebody I've known for so many years, a spiritual friend, spiritual brother, you know, who had been on a particular level in one of the forces in Nigeria for so many years. He had worked so hard quite diligent at his work, always commended by his bosses. But each time promotion came, it would elude him. You know, and he had got into the cadre of, you know, the senior officers. But was now to begin to cross to the cadre of the generals, as it were, in that particular sector of the armed forces. But year in, year out, every single year, promotion time will come and nothing will happen. It happened once, it happened twice, it happened a third time. And after a while, he was able to gain access to see the general overseer. And General Overseer gave only one counsel. He said, promotion is of the Lord. He says, when it is time for your promotion, or when God has promotion in store for you, nobody can stop it. No demon in hell can frustrate it. Promotion is of the Lord. So all those beings that God uses to physically promote us as just vessels that he uses. Maybe your boss, somebody in authority, somebody higher than you, maybe in your area of in your organization. They are just instruments that God uses. They are just vessels that God uses. But if God does not say yes to your promotion, even though you are working so hard at the promotion, even though you are pursuing so rigorously, it will not come. Something will just happen. Sometimes your boss could just say, we just promoted, but you are not promoted. And I thought your name was on that list. Okay, don't worry, it's too late. Okay, next year. Praise the Lord. But as long as you are in the will of God, walking in the will of God, it's just a matter of time. At God's appointed time, your promotion will come. Because promotion is of the Lord. It is he that pulls down one and lifts up another. For some, the promotion may come rapidly or it may be swift. For others, it may be delayed. But as long as, I said, as you are in the will of God, living a life pleasing to God, it may tarry, but it will surely come. And Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3 makes that very clear. It says, the vision is for an appointed time. Though it tarries, wait for it, because it will surely come. So that's a word to somebody here this morning. You have been toiling, you have been working, you have been pursuing that elevated position. You have been praying about it. You have been fasting concerning it. You have been doing all that you need to do. You have been commended by your bosses, but it has not come. Because why? It is for an appointed time. But wait for it. Do not faint. Do not give up. It will definitely come. And I know it's going to come this season. Why? Because this is a season of promotion. This is a season of promotion. It's a season of promotion. Our church has just been promoted as a church. We went into the convention as a church, a parish, and then also as a father that is, you know, an authority over 8 to 10 other parishes as a zonal headquarters. Even though for quite a number of years, the church, the parish had been long overdue for this kind of promotion, but it never came. For one reason or the other, it just never came. But at God's appointed time, it has come. Because we came out of the convention and with effect from 1st of September, we are now just not an ordinary parish. Not just a parish overseeing 8 to 10 parishes, but we are a parish overseeing 85 to 100 parishes. Because with effect from 1st of September 2016, Canaanland became a province headquarters. Praise the Lord. Now that is a great leap for the church. Father of 10 to father of 100. Praise the Lord. But at God's appointed time. Like I said, we walk towards it. Like I said, maybe one or two things happened that may have delayed it. But it was not just time. But at God's appointed time, it happened. And I know a promotion for the church is promotion for you and I. Why? Because the church is not the building. The church is not the edifice. The church is the people. So I can say confidently that because Canaanland has been promoted, this is a season of promotion for you, for everyone here present. Wait for it. Your promotion is near. Your promotion is near the corner. Tell your neighbor your promotion is around the corner. Wait for it. It will definitely come. Because this is the season of promotion. The spirit of promotion is in the house. Receive it. Say, I receive it. You didn't say it well. You didn't say it confidently. Say, I receive it. I receive promotion. The anointing for promotion is in the house. Tap into it. Say, I tap into anointing for promotion. Say, anointing for promotion. Anointing for promotion. Fall on me. Begin to pray. Begin to pray that. Pray that prayer. Fall on me. Anointing for promotion. Fall on me. Anointing for promotion. Be released upon me. Anointing for elevation. Fall on me. Fall on me. Fall on me. Fall on me this day. Fall on me this season. This is the time of my promotion. This is the season of my elevation. Anointing for promotion. Fall on me. Fall on me. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it in this season of promotion. I receive it in this season of elevation. I receive it. I receive the blessings. I receive the favor. I receive the multiples. I receive it. I receive it. Anointing for promotion. Fall on me. In the mighty name of Jesus. I prophesy to your life that the manifestation of your promotion will not exceed this month in the mighty name of Jesus. Promotion can come in different forms and different ways. For some, because the promotion that many of us are familiar with is when, you know, your boss raises your pay. Or when you are moved from one level, maybe assistant manager to full manager. Or you are an officer, you now move to management level. Or you are just an ordinary person. You know, there are some people who come, they may work in banks, but when you look at their cards, it just says, you say something like marketing. So that means they have not really seriously started to climb that ladder. It's just marketing. So you are just one of many in marketing. Praise the Lord. But when they begin to give you a designation, then you have started. And I know that from this month you shall begin to receive a clear-cut designation in the mighty name of Jesus. As many as are ordinary rank and file, they begin to move closer, begin to receive promotion towards the officer level in Jesus' name. And as many as are officer will begin to move towards, by way of promotion, the managerial level in Jesus' name. As many as are in managerial level begin to move up to the level of directors in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus, because this is your season. So that's what most of us are very, very familiar with when we hear promotion, promotion at work, increase in pay, change in title, and what have you. But promotion comes in different ways and different forms, as it comes at different times. For example, somebody who used to be barren, who was barren for so many years, now conceives, and after 9 months of conception, brings forth a child, has gone through even double promotion. Because barrenness to conception, that is one. And the fact that you have conceived doesn't mean you will give birth. Abi, conception to childbirth is another promotion. Praise the Lord. That was the story of Sarah in Genesis chapter 21 verses 1 to 6. The story of Rachel in Genesis chapter 30, verses 22 to 24.
Promotion can also come by way of somebody who had been blind for so many years. Or from birth in some cases, and suddenly was able to see. That also happened in the case of blind Bartimaeus. Mark chapter 11. He had been blind for so many years. Then one day he heard that Jesus Christ was passing through. You can see that. You see, you can tell when a person is expecting promotion. You can tell when a person is expecting a change of God. Because when you are when you are promoted, a lot of things change about you. Let us face it. The way you walk changes. The way you talk changes. The way you move yourself changes. Even your swagger changes. Your smile changes. You know, everything about you changes. Because the levels have changed. But this man was expectant. Immediately he heard that Jesus was in town, and he knew he had an anointing for promotion. He knew he could change his situation. He leapt up. They said, and was shouting, "Jesus, son of David, keep quiet, keep quiet, keep quiet." Who are those saying keep quiet? Those who were at the top. Praise the Lord. Many times when people climb to the top, they don't allow others. They even remove the ladder so that they'll be the only ones at the top. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Only very few are at the top. Praise the Lord. So that's why it's only God that can lift up some. Others will not lift you up. Sometimes relations may not lift you up. Sometimes your problem may be your family, because they are pushing you down, preventing you from climbing the ladder. Praise the Lord. But we thank God, because we have somebody who's in control of the ladder. We have somebody who takes charge of the ladder. We have somebody who determines those who climb. We have God. We have somebody who controls everything when it comes to elevation. So no matter your detractor, no matter the enemies or those trying to pull you down, our God is the one that controls the instrument of promotion. So on that day, he lifted up and said, "Today, my situation must change. My story must change." Bible records there that Jesus Christ was just on his way. He was passing through Jericho. When a man's promotion comes, nothing can stop it. He was not part of Jesus' itinerary for that day. He was passing through. But he knew that something was to happen that day. And by the time his story was over, praise the Lord, not only had his sight been restored, but his life had been restored. Because his life was on full stop as long as he was blind. Because as a blind person, he was subject to others. He was dependent on others. He couldn't do much without others. But the day he regained his sight, praise the Lord, the Bible says that he followed Jesus on the road by himself. Before, he couldn't do that because his story had changed. He had been promoted. You shall be promoted this month. As many as are spiritually blind, your eyes will be opened this month. As many like Bartimaeus who has been on the same spot for so many years, you shall begin to move this month in the mighty name of Jesus. Promotion can also come by way of healing. A woman of so many, many years who had had this infirmity referred to as the issue of blood for about 13 years had gone from place to place, from doctor to doctor, Mark chapter 5, 24 to 34. But one day, her story changed. And she was promoted. Can you imagine if you have blood constantly gushing out of you, constantly, whether it was all around in private, in public, it would be a thing of shame now. You know, because people would just begin to wonder, what is this? A smell somewhere, they just don't know where it is from and all that. And eventually they will zero it to a particular person and all that. You can imagine the stain. You can imagine the shame. So when that ceased, it was a mighty promotion for her. Praise the Lord. Am I getting somewhere this morning? Promotion can also come by way of somebody who had a vision, who had a dream, but whose dream attempts were made to truncate it by even his brothers, his family members. This man went from sharing his dream to the pit. From the pit, he was sold into slavery, taken to a foreign land in Egypt. Praise the Lord. From arriving in Egypt, he became a houseboy. For me, houseboy, they told lies against him and he landed in prison. Praise the Lord. But from that prison cell, he landed in the office of the Prime Minister of Egypt. That's why I say that when your time comes, no one can stop it. No one can do anything about it. Praise the Lord. That's the story of Joseph, Genesis chapter 42, verses 6 to 7. So many, many other examples. Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These are slaves, praise the Lord. Because what I'm saying, they were under captivity. They were people ordinary that were not reckoned with. Even they were very well educated. But then in chapter 3, verses 13 to 30, talks about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, how they took important positions as ministers in the cabinet of the king at that time. And Daniel even being a top minister there. A top administrator there. Why? Because God himself had promoted them. Also, the story of Esther. Esther chapter 2 verse 17. Esther 2:17. Who was Esther? Where was Esther from? The Bible says he pulls down one, he lifts up another. Vashti, Queen Vashti was pulled down. There was a vacancy. Esther was pulled up. The Bible says, and the king loved Esther above all the women, and she obtained the grace and favor in his sight. This morning you are not playing grace and favor before your bosses, before those in authority over you, in the area of business, in all your endeavors, in the mighty name of Jesus. She obtained Esther 2:17. Esther 2:17, she obtained grace and favor in the sight more than all the virgins, so that he set the royal crown upon her head and made her queen instead of Vashti. Made her queen instead of Vashti. You'll be preferred amongst others in the mighty name of Jesus. You'll be lifted up this month. You'll be lifted high this month. Promotion can also take the form of a tenant for so many years becoming a landlord. What else do you want? Or somebody who had been using Volkswagen becoming the owner of a Volkswagen. Or an employee becoming an employer or becoming an entrepreneur. Can come by way of a student becoming a graduate. You can come by way of a disciple becoming an apostle. The 12 disciples, as we know them, for 3.5 years, they were disciples. They were being taught. They were being tutored. They were being trained. But after 3.5 years, they became apostles. They were promoted to apostles, those who were sent. You will be promoted this month. You'll be elevated this month in the mighty name of Jesus. So while we are waiting for our promotion or the manifestation of our promotion, what should be our attitude, even as I close this morning? Number one, we should remain faithful to God. We should remain faithful to God while we are waiting for our promotion. Don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. Don't abandon the faith. Don't say it's not happening, it's not working, nothing is happening, so you move away. No, remain faithful to God and to his word. Number two, stay in the place of your calling. Don't begin to run from place to place, from pillar to post, because many people seem to be in this area of business. Many people seem to be doing this. So you want to join them and also do the same thing. What is your destiny? What have you been called to do? What is that thing that God has invested skills and talents, you know, in you for? What is God's purpose for your life? Stay in the place of that purpose. Stay in the place of that calling. So when this angel comes to bring your promotion to you, he will find you still there where God has placed you. What do you do while you are waiting for your manifestation of your promotion? Constantly remind God of his promises. Continue to remind God of his promises. What do you do as you are waiting for that time of promotion? Be diligent in what you are doing. A lazy man has no right to expect promotion. A man who is sloppy at his business has no right to expect promotion. The Bible says in Proverbs, it says, "Seest thou a man diligent in his affairs, he shall walk, he shall eat, he shall dine with great men, and no longer with mean men." Diligent in his affairs. What do you do as you are waiting your promotion? Have an attitude like that of Habakkuk. As we read in Habakkuk chapter 3, 17 to 18. Habakkuk chapter 3, 17 to 18. Have that kind of attitude. What is that kind of attitude? Let us read together. 1, 2, go. "Although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruit be in the vines, the labor of the olive shall not fail, and the field shall yield no meat, the flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls." Verse 18. "Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation." Give us that in New English Translation, please. New Living Translation, please. Let us read together again. 1, 2, go. "Even though the fig trees have no blossoms, and there are no grapes on the vines, even though the olive crop fails, and the fields lie empty and barren, even though the flocks die in the fields, and the cattle barns are empty, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in the God of my salvation." How many are ready to rejoice in the Lord this morning? Habakkuk was saying that even though the promotion hasn't come, even though the promises are yet to come to pass, even though that breakthrough has not come, but I will rejoice in the God of my salvation. So our attitude should be one of rejoicing. Rejoice forevermore, the Bible tells us. Rejoice, 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 rejoice. Because it's just a matter of time, the promotion will come. I have a feeling that a voice of rejoicing causes even the hosts of heaven to speed up the promotion that is to come. When they keep hearing rejoicing from a particular source, when they keep, your rejoicing keeps reminding them that I am waiting, no, I'm waiting, no, I'm waiting, no, I'm waiting. No. God himself will say that, as a matter of fact, we said it was going to be 2019, but I think this guy cannot wait anymore. He has been delayed for 2 months. Can we fast track it? There are some promotions that are fast tracked. There are some promotions that are pushed forward. There are some promotions that are placed above others. Praise the Lord. And I know the key is in the rejoicing. Is there anybody here who is willing to rejoice in the God of the salvation? Even as he has wasted promotion, let us rise this morning. There's somebody here who's able to say, "Thank you, Lord. Even though it has not happened, even though I'm still waiting, but I thank you. I rejoice in my salvation. I rejoice in your promises. I rejoice in the fact of being alive. I rejoice in the fact of you being my Father. I joy in you, oh Lord, because I know that it's not a matter of time. I know you are walking behind the scenes, because I know you have not forgotten me. I know you are not forgotten me. So I rejoice this morning. I bless your name, oh Lord." Begin to thank him. Just begin to thank him. And begin to thank him this morning. 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 Begin to rejoice. Begin to rejoice in his salvation. Begin to rejoice in your salvation. Begin to thank the Almighty Father, the controller of promotion, the one with the anointing for promotion. Oh, the one that lifts up one and brings out another. Oh yes, the Lord of hosts, the man of war, the commander of the hosts of heavens, the one that is not accountable to anyone. Begin to rejoice this morning. 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 Misata brakata babashete. Messi Karabayaka Baba Sete Bobo. Ira Robo Shinda Brakata Baba. Oh yes, Lord. 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 Oh. I will exalt you, Lord. For thou art lifted me.
above my enemy. Your banner over me is Lord. I will exalt you, Lord. For thou art lifted me above my enemy. Your banner over me is Lord. Hallelujah.
Special, because you are expecting a special thing, you are expecting a different thing.
You are expecting a promotion. You are expecting elevation. Let your thanksgiving offering be elevated so that God will know what you are expecting, so that the host of heavens will not be in any doubt. Oh, yes. School. From tomorrow, many of them will begin to resume for the new session. So we want to commit them in the hands of the Almighty Father. We are going to lay hands on them. We are going to anoint them. Anointing for success. Anointing for fruitfulness. Anointing for promotion. Anointing for excellence in their studies. Even as they go forth this morning. Our children and every student in the house, we are going to lay hands on them and anoint them as they begin a new session. They will drop their offering. We shall lay hands on them, anoint them even as they go forth.
Father, to you says, we lift up your name, oh God, there is no one like you. Amen. Your hands together. Lord, we lift up your name. You are worthy, Jesus. You are worthy.